a very special day here on Studio 10 as we take part in a live Harbour Bridge climb with inspiring teenager Eric Barrett. Our roving reporter Robbo caught up with Eric last week. Let's take a look at his incredible story.
Your newborn son is not going to survive. Karen Barrett heard those shattering words 16 years ago when she gave birth to her son, Eric.
We knew straight away that there was a problem. He was in ICU for a couple of months and I was told after a couple of weeks that he was going to have cerebral palsy and that there was a significant injury that occurred and that he may not walk or talk or he may not even make it.
He survived, but according to doctors, Eric had a life sentence, imprisoned in his own body. Single mother Karen refused to accept the diagnosis, and as Eric's first few hours turned into days, despair turned into hope.
There was always something in Eric's eyes that would make you smile and know that no matter what, it was going to be okay.
For 8 long years, Karen searched tirelessly for a miracle. Finally, she turned to alternative treatments and the helping hands of physical therapist Luke Waters.
He was in a powered wheelchair, just a tiny little kid that came up to me and it was just sad to see him there and deep down I thought and knew that I could make a difference to his life.
He learned how to crawl and slowly developed more skills until finally, after 4 years, Eric began to walk with a frame.
When he started to walk, it was a bit of a dream for me.
He was determined to walk on his own and live life to the max. He continued to train tirelessly until the day he stood up and took his very first steps. And while the steps were painstakingly small, for Eric, they were monumental.
I look at the photo and think, wow, is that how far we will come?
He tells me quite regularly, at least once a week, how beautiful his life is, and life is great.
Now this inspiring 16-year-old has set his sights on a new challenge, conquering 1,400 steps to the top of the Sydney Harbour Bridge and prove to the world that you can accomplish whatever you set your mind to.
Wow, what an extraordinary young man. Our roving reporter Robbo is with Eric now as they prepare to climb the Harbour Bridge. Robbo, this is, I guess, Eric's Everest. How's he feeling today about this climb?
Well, he's feeling very excited, Sarah, and why wouldn't you be? Today is a perfect day for dreams to come true. And a very quick recap, we just saw Eric there. He was told that he wouldn't survive. He did. We were told that he wouldn't talk or walk. And 4 years ago, he took his first unassisted steps, and that is pretty amazing. And as you said, it is his Everest. So forget actually Mount Everest. Forget the Grand Canyon. We are here at this place of national identity and beauty and a beacon of hope. And, of course, Eric, are you excited about this?
Yeah, I am.
Absolutely you are. And, Karen, we're obviously joined by 30 of Eric's closest friends and family. Guys, are we ready to go? Absolutely. Now, Karen, even 5 years ago, you would have thought that this was something that could not be possible.
Oh, wouldn't have even imagined it in a million years. Yeah, impossible.
Well, Eric has shown that anything is possible, and he's going to do that again today. So this is Feel Good TV at its best, and it's only on Studio 10. Sarah?
Oh, you're a good man. Thank you, Robbo. A helicopter live over the bridge bringing you live updates on Eric's progress throughout the show. It should be a really good morning. It's actually a really hard climb.
Incredibly hard climb. And to be honest, I'm more worried about Robbo. His fitness levels are not where they should be.
Good hair, though. Look at his hair.
Love it.
Right now, after years of tireless training, Eric is climbing the Sydney Harbour Bridge. Our roving reporter, Robbo, is with him. Where are you at, Robbo?
Oh, Sarah, we are about halfway up this beautiful beast that they call the coat hanger. And Eric, how are you feeling so far? We're almost there. How are you feeling?
It's amazing.
View. Look at that. Now, the thing is, guys, as we saw in that package there, that he didn't walk until 4 years ago. So before that, the only way he could get around was in a motorised wheelchair. And one of the great things is when I met the family a couple of weeks ago, I saw that wheelchair in the garage and it was just collecting dust, which was an amazing image because he's worked so hard to be able to do this. We've also got Luke, who is Eric's physiotherapist. Luke, how is it today? How is it to see him doing this?
Yeah, the smile on his face says it all. It's amazing.
It really is quite amazing. It's absolutely inspirational stuff. And we're going to cross back to you live when Eric conquers the Sydney Harbour Bridge climb.
Yay, Robbo. Thumbs up, indeed, go Eric. Well, all morning we've been following the inspiring journey of 16-year-old Eric Barrett, who was diagnosed with cerebral palsy at birth. His parents were told by doctors all those years ago that he would never survive, and if he did, he wouldn't walk or talk. 16 years later, Eric is proving doctors wrong. And this is the moment he reached the top of the Sydney Harbour Bridge. 14. Steps is what it took. Amazingly, Eric only learned to walk 4 years ago through tireless dedication and hard work with his physiotherapist. Our roving reporter, Robbo, has been following the story and joins us now. Robbo, it must have been an amazing moment to see it all happen in person.
It really was absolutely amazing, Sarah. It really is the feel-good story of the year. And I'm here with the man himself. Everyone, let's give Eric a big round of applause. Hooray! Absolutely. On the summit. Eric, you finally did it. How does it feel, buddy?
My underwater view is absolutely amazing.
The view is absolutely amazing. Now, Karen, you would have thought, think back 5 years ago, you would never think that you'd be standing here on the top of the Sydney Harbour Bridge with Eric.
No, absolutely not. Not a thought in the world. We did actually think a while ago, years ago, about doing the bridge climb, but counted it out because of Eric in the wheelchair. So, yeah, fantastic.
But he certainly has conquered it. And, Luke, this must be an amazing moment. Was there ever a time where you thought that he couldn't do this?
I guess from day one, we never knew where he can get, so it's a little overwhelming to be up here now with Eric and from where he's come from to where he is today and in this amazing place. So it's just truly great.
It really is amazing. And the great thing about Eric is that he always wants people to make the best out of their own lives. So he's got a website, ericsgiveback.com.au, and all funds raised there go to the Danica Clark Foundation, which helps sports people, disadvantaged sports people, get some scholarships. And also a massive thanks to bridgeclimb.com.au for all of their help today in helping us get there. Look at this amazing view. Everyone, Eric has done an amazing job. What do we think? It's fantastic. Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. Beautiful. Eric, give us a thumbs up, buddy.
Oh, what a remarkable young man. I tell you what, great reporting, Robbo. If that doesn't put you in a good mood on a Monday morning, I don't know what will. Thank you very much. That website, again, is called ericsgiveback.com.au. Eric, what a champion you are. Congrats from everyone here. We've got to take a real quick break, but there's more of Studio 10 when we return.